Not me. You're ridiculous. Not me. Right there.
Harry.
You want me to pick you up?
River kittens.
Oh, now you see food? Hold on. How old are they? The little one is 7 months old, she's 9 months old. Harry's the most athletic otter I've ever seen in my life. You could give another stick to two. And who had the other one too before? Give them another two. Because I want to keep these guys out of the water right now. Yeah, they're legit hunters. For sure. And then give whoever has two more.
No, it's different.
And then I'll take the rest of the fish. You're gonna hurt yourself, dude. Now I'm gonna have to build that glass thing higher. That's the most concern. You're really gonna hurt yourself, bro. Give me the rest of the thing.
Jeez.
We're hoping they pair up because otters are monogamous. So they will actually spend their whole life together. Give me that tail.
And if the age they do that, or a little bit later?
Between 6 months and a year and a half. But these guys are really immature. So they'll be closer to a year and a half. Yeah, I know. I don't know what's going on. I'm waiting on more fish, okay?
How long do they sleep for?
They go to, like, on a night like tonight, because of all the people that come out, they'll go to sleep by, like, 7:30, and they won't wake up until, like, 6:30 in the morning. But normally, they don't go to bed till, like, 7 or 9 o'clock, and then they wake up at, like, 6:30. But by the time we get home from here, they are...
And then when you keep them like at your place, do you have certain animals near each other because they're friendly or just kind of?
All animals with their own kind, except for sheep, goats, donkeys, and cows.
Okay, come over here.
They all is introduce you all to this incredible otter who doesn't normally get a harness on, so we're going to start working with him and he'll play with it for a little bit. While I'm walking around getting super close to you guys, whatever you do, do not reach out and try to touch or pet him. You want to hang out with Dad? I will tell you when it's okay to pet him, and once I tell everybody it's okay to pet him, I'll make an announcement, but then I'll show everyone here exactly how to pet him. Does everybody understand that? Awesome. Now, if you have not met our kangaroos yet, the next kangaroo encounter will start a few minutes after this one ends. So make sure you stick around. It's included in the park admission, so don't leave until you have met our kangaroo as well. But in the meantime, who's ready to meet Harry Otter? All right, so his name is Harry. Harry is a baby otter. He is 7 months old. Now, there are 13 species of otter on this planet. He is an Asian small-clawed otter. These guys are found living in the wild in parts of Asia and India. Asian small-clawed otters, to me, are one of the most special otters on the planet. And the reason for that is they hold the title in a lot of different arenas. One of the things they own is that they are the smallest species of otter on this planet. When he grows up, he will only be 2 feet long and 10 pounds. Right now, he only weighs almost 4 pounds. So he's got a lot of room to grow. Now, you want to play with that? Not only are the Asian small-clawed otters the smallest species of otter on the planet, they're also one of the most vocal species of otter on the planet. So he can communicate really well, and they have a pretty large vocabulary. As they grow, it even expands and gets larger. So they own the title of being the smallest. They're also the most vocal, but they are also one more thing. They are the otter that spends the least amount of time in the water, which is pretty awesome for us. So a lot of times when we play with them, they're dry. Is pretty cool. Although today I had to feed them a bunch, so for 5 minutes I knew they weren't jumping in the water and be all soaking wet all over me. So you've got the smallest otter on the planet, the most vocal otter on the planet, and the otter that spends the least amount of time in the water on the planet, which is pretty cool. Now, these guys are obviously really good in the water, but you probably assume that they're born that way, and they are not. Asian small-clawed otters, believe it or not, are terrified of the water when they're babies. And the reason for that is they're born blind. They are unable to see for the first 3 to 4 weeks of their life. Their mother builds a nest for their babies, and they don't build it too close to the water because they don't want these otters venturing into the water unable to see or swim. What mom does at 3 to 4 months old, grabs one of its otters at a time and brings them down to the body of water. Now, what I'm about to tell you might seem really mean, but when the mom teaches their babies how to swim, they actually grab them with their long teeth around their neck and they pull them into the water and they hold them under the water for long periods of time. And what they're trying to teach their baby in the nicest way they possibly can is they're trying to teach them that they can hold their breath for long periods of time. Otters can hold their breath for up to 8 minutes when they become adults. You want to play with that? Is that fun for you? Very nice. So.